Hello, in section 6, about separating concerns using type services. In the previous section, we have learned about Angular forms, how to create a reactive form, implement form handling and form validation. In this section at the beginning, I will introduce you into our services and DI, which is dependency injection. Then we will create a very simple service and we will inject that service into our component class. At the end, we will inject a service into a service. What are services and dependency injection? So in this video, we are going to focus on dependency injection and then I will introduce you into our services. So what is dependency injection? Dependency injection is a software design pattern that allows the removal of hard-coded dependencies and makes it possible to change them. So first, let's look at the problem we have when we don't use dependency injection. In a car class constructor, we are creating a new instance of engine and doors. So the car class creates everything it needs inside in the constructor, which means it's not flexible and it's hard to test. So what if we want to create a new car but with other engine? Or what if we want to create a car with more or less doors? But there is a solution. As you can see on the slide, an engine instance and doors instance is created outside the car. A car constructor contains only a definition of doors and engine. So why it is a big win? We can pass any kind of an engine, for example V8 or a spider. The same is with doors, so it's really easy to test a car class. When it comes to the Angular, it provides its own dependency injection framework. Services. While developing web application, we want to reuse the same code across multiple components, or share data between these components, or fetch data and then reuse. That's why Angular services are responsible to do. As you can see on the slide, for example, service A is responsible for fetching some data from some endpoint. And we can inject that service to the component A or component B. Service B could be responsible for the authorization. So we can inject that service also in the component A and to the another component C. And so on. So in simple words, Angular service is just a function that allows us to access properties and methods that are defined in the function. And we can create a tons of services that do something, which is really cool and simple using Angular. In this video, I've introduced you into a dependency injection, DI, and services.